Sometimes she's a little crazy.
Yes, she is.
And she don't understand how much her dad loves her.
Amen.
And she's upset right now because of the fact that her baby looks just like his grandpa. Amen. So, but that's all right. Because she looked just like me.
Exactly.
Amen. So I thank God for all of you. Thank God, I don't know what to call her, my cousin, my sister, one I grew up with. I just love her with all my heart. Thank God for her being here, Sister Tasia. Thank God for her. Amen. Love her. I took her through hell when we were kids. I kicked her down a hill, made her roll down the hill, yeah. And after that day, I ran from her every time I saw her. But I love her. My little cousins back there, amen. And I'm not going to be very long at all. The Lord gave me something to give to you all. And it's going to sound a little strange. It sounded strange to me when he gave it to me. And I'm kind of piggybacking off something that I taught on a Monday night. And what I taught was, amen, this is the message that God gave me to give to you. So you look at your neighbor and you talk to somebody. Can y'all going to help me preach again today?
Yes, sir.
Look at somebody and say, neighbor, find your glory.
Find your glory.
And give it to God.
And give it to God. All right, right now.
Find your glory and give it to God. I made the statement on the other day that God does not mind you having glory. Matter of fact, God gives you glory. When he created you also to be glorious, to have glory, to look good, to be the best at what you do. We have glory in what we do. What you do best, they will say you're glorious. One is gone. His name was Johnny Cochran. Everybody went after him.
Oh, yeah.
All the guilty folks wanted him to represent them when it came to, amen, a defense attorney.
Amen.
Because of the fact that he was good at what he did. So that was his glory. Amen? Believe it or not, I'm only going to be a few minutes, I believe. Then you have, amen, some of those that are in the Bible. You got one named David. And David was chosen, amen, to be the successor. Or not even the successor, if you will, but one to take the place of King Saul. Amen, a king. A man after God's own heart. A pastor is a man after God's own heart. The church then was set up as the church now, and people don't understand, amen, how the church is set up. There is an order, and I'm excited today even about the order and what God is doing right now. I want to tell you, Revival Center, today in this service, you look good.
Amen.
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 So, David's glory, one of them, because some of us are glorious in more ways than one. But one of them was that harp. Everybody knew of him. If you want somebody, amen, that's going to play and that's going to soothe you and that's going to make you feel the way you need to feel, we know a young man named David. So he went in and got the young man to come and play for the king. And the king had been attacked by a demonic spirit. And that demonic spirit would come into him and drive him crazy to the point to where it would make him scratch himself and rip at himself and do different types of things that demons will cause you to do. I want you to understand that demon spirits will cause you to be uneasy.
Yes, sir.
Demon spirits, amen, will cause you to be uncomfortable. They will mess you up. Oh my, but God is a deliverer. And not only is God a deliverer, but God blesses men and gives men anointing to do certain things. So David was glorious in the playing of his It was so anointed that it cast the devils out. It calmed the spirits. It made the devil come under subjection. Oh my God. Of the anointing of God. So that was one of his glories. Come on, somebody. Samson had a glory.
Yes, he did.
He had glory. He had glory. And his glory was his strength.
Yes, it was.
A matter of fact, his name went way before him. If you mention the name Samson, people who never saw him knew exactly who he was.
Right.
A matter of fact, it was glory because of the fact that it lets us know that Samson did not look like what he was capable of.
Uh-huh.
Come on, somebody. Amen. It looked like, take for instance, amen. You look at David and Goliath. David was a little bitty boy to Goliath, amen. And Goliath was a giant. He did not look like he was able to slay a giant, but he was able to do that because of the fact I can do all things through
Christ.
Come on, somebody. Christ, the anointed one. Y'all better hear me. Come from Christo, meaning the a special endowment of the anointing. So the anointing was working then, so I can do all things through the anointing.
Yes.
Y'all hear me? Come on, somebody. So we get to the point to where Samson's glory was his strength. And one day he slayed 1,000 men with just a jawbone of an ass. Come on, somebody. He killed 100 men. Come on, somebody. And every time you look at him, he was stacking up people, the enemy that was coming after him.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody. Woo! I feel like preaching a little bit. And we don't even have to look at and the Bible characters, because we even have glory.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at somebody else that I call ordinary, but we would call extraordinary. When you look at Michael Jordan, Come on, somebody. His glory is that basketball.
Yeah.
And everybody looked at him. Everybody said his name. Anybody that didn't even know what basketball was knew the name Michael Jordan. Come on, somebody. And that was his glory. Everybody said his name. And I want you to understand that sometimes we take our glory and we do the wrong thing with it. We take our glory and we hand it over to the enemy.
Yes.
But it's important that we learn what we ought to do with the glory that God has given us.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I feel like preaching. She took it. She took it and tried to kill him, tried to murder him, tried to destroy him, she was the enemy. Oh my God. And she came into his camp and took what was his.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. And then what they in turn did, they turned around and took him into their camp. But what they didn't know is that God is a forgiving God.
Yes, he is.
God is an almighty God. God is a powerful God. So he ended up going into the enemy's camp, taking back what was stolen from him. Y'all hear me? And in the end thereof, the Bible declares that he killed more because he was created to kill the enemy.
Yes.
That was his glory.
He's the word.
And he killed more in one day than he did in his entire lifetime.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody. Some of us might have fell off track a little bit. But that's okay. Why is it okay? Because look at your neighbor and say, I'm still here.
I'm still here.
And I still got faith.
And I still got faith.
Woo! Grace is still sufficient.
Woo!
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So we get to the point to where we're going to have to get like Samson if we are in that place to where we have slacked, where we have not given our all, whether we have done something that it is against the will and the ways of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody. Let me get back to Samson in a minute. We're going to get there. But we take our glory. Find your glory. You got to find what it is that God chose you for.
Yes.
It might be your personality. It might be the knowledge you have. It might be, oh my God, you don't know the gift that he placed in you, saving, whatever it might be. Find your glory. And then you give glory to God. You understand that?
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. One of a woman's glory. A woman. One of your glories, one of your main glory. The Bible says your glory is what? Huh? Somebody know the Bible. Your hair. Glory of the woman is her hair. Now, I don't know if that includes weave. Oh, weave, it's hair. And somebody said, I bought it from Big King. It's mine. It's mine. I paid for it. Is that your hair? Yes, it is.
Yes.
So, that is your glory. Come on, somebody. Just like Samson, his hair was also part of his glory. But a woman's hair is her glory. But you take what God gave to you and you give it back to him.
That's right.
You look at Mary Magdalene, one that was a whore in the beginning, a prostitute. Come on, somebody. But God called her out and he saved her. And when he saved her, come on, somebody, she was willing and ready to give everything that she had right back to God.
Yes.
Even to the point of giving God all of her glory. She took all of the expensive oils and ointments and she began to prepare Jesus for his burial. I don't hear nobody. And she humiliated herself, humbled herself, got all the way down on her knees and her side and as far as she could go to pour the oils on his feet. And she used her glory to wipe the oils off of his feet. Her hair. Come on, somebody. We need to find our glory. Bring it and lay it at his feet. Are y'all catching this? This is what he gave me to give you today. So, no matter where you have been and what you have done, where you are in life, it's time that you, amen, some of you have to get your glory back. Some of you, the devil has tried to take your glory. It may have been to, but some way or another, if he got it, you gave it to him.
That's it.
Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Because if you want it, you that. Oh, just like in relationship, we say, she made me so mad, I can't take it, I can't stand it, I got to holler, I got to do this, I got to do that. You don't have to do anything, because she's not making you do it. You have control over you. Come on, somebody. Because this is my mind.
Hallelujah.
I think what I want to think. Come on, somebody. I let in my mind what I want to let in my mind.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. I allow what I want to allow.
Yes, Lord.
But it's time for us to humble ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody. If any man will come after me, the first thing that man, woman, boy, or girl is to do is to deny themselves, take off their cross, and follow Jesus. Yeah. I'm almost through.
Thank you.
Almost through.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Yes, Lord.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. So, we're justified by faith. We're justified by faith. Justified, just as if I've never sinned. Justified. It puts us in the right place. Come on, justified. We are able and capable. It is okay for us to be there. We are justified. In other words, we have the right because of our faith. Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And by whom also we have access. I want you to understand that access, when you have access to something, that means you can go in there. Somebody asked me for a key to the church. You have access. Whenever you feel like it, you can come in here, get on your knees and pray, because you have access to the building. Come on, somebody. So by that faith, we have access by faith into his grace. And that grace is undeserved favor. We don't deserve it. Come on, somebody. We have all sinned against God. We have all done wrong in the sight of God. But when we get down and have faith and do what we're supposed to, now we have access into his favor that is not deserved. Look at your neighbor and say, I don't deserve it, but he keep on blessing me. I don't deserve it, but he keep on helping me. I don't deserve it, but he keeps on loving me. We have access into his grace, wherein we stand and we rejoice in the hope of the Lord. Rejoicing in him coming back to us. The hope in everything that he said, every one of his promises. We rejoice over his promises. Look at your neighbor and say, that's faith.
That's faith.
That is faith to rejoice over a promise.
Ooh,
y'all didn't even catch that, did you?
Yes, right.
And not only so, but we glory in tribulation. Hallelujah. Also knowing that tribulation works patience, patience experience hope, and a hope making us not ashamed, because the love of God is spread abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. Now I want you to understand, when God gives you glory, he don't mind you having it, as long as you turn around and give him the glory. See, because of the fact that we are God's and we belong to him, because we belong to him. Come on, somebody. We look good when we're going through. And when we look good when we're going through, can you imagine when you go to the school and your kid is dealing with this and dealing with that, but they looking good and they looking like this, you are going to receive glory because of the fact your kid has glory on their life.
Yes.
Do you understand where I'm coming from?
Thank you.
So we need to take our glory and give it back to God.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes. Let's have our hands and tell the Lord, thank you.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.